I think the biggest challenge is it's not that much of a challenge so much. It's just a desire to do it, realizing every day that this is something that is important, not important just because we want to diversify, but you know, it's important for our returns. I mean, I think you mentioned the stat up front that a more diverse workforce creates better returns. And I think the reason for that is that you have a more diverse perspective and opinion around the table, and it helps you think about investments better. I think the challenge to the industry historically has been, you know, I think that when you think about private equity, it seems like a very big industry, but by and large, most of these firms are very small firms. These are 20 person shops managing, you know, multiple billion dollars. And there, until recently, it's not been really institutionalized. And it's not until it become institutionalized that people start thinking about issues of diversity and inclusion. It's no surprise that two of the folks you have on here come from places that in the last 10 years have really become institutionalized places, Apollo and Blackstone. And when you become institutionalized, one of the things you start thinking, you've got to start thinking about is, well, I got to broaden my talent. The pool of people from which I'm going to draw has to broaden out. It can't just be my friends and the kids that I, the people that I know from the college that I went to, because otherwise you on law of numbers, you won't have enough talent. But when you're managing a...
So is there less pressure than on the middle market space because they're kind of a little more under the radar? Is that sort of what you're...
I think historically there has been less pressure, but as the larger firms have started to really take this seriously, and have said, hey, listen, we are institutionalizing and we are going to seek diverse talent. And hey, look, it's actually improving my returns. What happens is then your LPs start pushing and saying, well, hold on a second. Like Apollo and Blackstone are doing this and they're seeing better returns. We got to start thinking about this in the middle market, and we got to start thinking about this on the lower market. And hopefully it builds on each other. The second thing is that as you get more people like me who are at the higher part of the rank, part of the job is to say, hey, listen, I got to pull people up behind me. And, you know, your statistic is in some ways mind-boggling that 98% of the capital is controlled. I mean, that's a mind-boggling statistic. Part of my job and people like Vern and others is to, as you're going up, to create opportunity for people coming behind you so that you can continue to diversify and have more women, more people of color who are coming up, and that'll help change the industry. It's not going to change. It doesn't change overnight, but over time, I think folks like Blackstone and Apollo leading, and then the push that we're seeing now from our LPs is very important. And I think that's one of the reasons that you're seeing a lot of people in the mid-market now start to recognize that having representation from women and more minorities is incredibly important to the sustainability of the business.